Good morning everyone. Today we will discuss the very important concept, that is the centripetal force. Centripetal force. Okay. So as you know, the body, when the body rotating in a circular pattern, if the body or any particle is rotating in a circular manner, then there are two forces are acting on this particle. Okay, in that first force is known as the centripetal force. Okay, so when the particle is rotating along the circle, or along the circumference of circle, then on this particle there are two forces acting. First, in that first force is what? Centripetal force. Okay, so centripetal force means what? It is a force acting on a particle which is performing UCM. UCM means what? Uniform circular motion. Uniform circular motion, what will happen? In uniform circular motion, the speed is constant. The speed is constant, but velocity continuously changes. Okay. If the velocity is here, it is velocity is like this. If the particle is here, then velocity is like this. So everywhere the velocity direction continuously changes, but speed remains the constant. Okay. The force which acts along the radius and towards the center is known as the centripetal force. For example, if the particle is here, the force will act towards the center along the radius. Matlab, this is the radius. Along the radius, the force will act and towards the center. Towards the center means the force will act towards the center. So this force is known as the centripetal force. If the particle is here, the centripetal force will act like this. The centripetal force will act like this. This centripetal force keep the particle in circular motion. If there is no force, then particle will go away from the center or away from the this circle. Okay. So there is one force which keep the force or which keep the particle to move in a circle. Okay. So that force is known as the centripetal force. I hope you understood. Centripetal force is the force which is along the radius and towards the center. It always acts towards the center. Okay, so this is the center. It always acts towards the center. Now, so there is one, as per the Newton's laws of motion, as per Newton's laws of motion, everyone knows Newton's law of motion is equal to force is equal to mass into acceleration. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. This is the second law of Newton's law of motion. Okay, so F is equal to ma. F is equal to, that is, so force is equal to mass into acceleration. So second law of Newton's laws of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So this force we will consider as the centripetal force. So this FCP indicates what? CP indicates centripetal. F indicates force. So force CP. So already we discussed here, centripetal force is equal to FCP. Okay. So that FCP we are taken. So FCP is equal to mass into acceleration. But we know already we discussed the derivation for radial acceleration, or acceleration is equal to V into omega. Another formula, acceleration is equal to V square upon R. Another formula, acceleration is equal to R into omega square. Okay. So this V is nothing but linear velocity. Omega indicates what? Angular velocity. Again, R indicates what? Radius. And omega also, it is angular velocity. So these formulas we derived. Okay, so we will substitute this acceleration in this formula. What will happen? FCP is equal to m as it is. We will substitute first formula, acceleration is equal to V omega. So A is equal to V omega, we will substitute here. So m as it is, A is nothing but V omega. A is nothing but phi omega, that is equal to, again we will keep the m as it is, a is equal to v square upon r, a is equal to v square upon r. Then again m as it is, acceleration is equal to r omega square, r omega square. So fcp is having three formulas. Fcp is equal to m into v into omega, that is equal to m into v square upon r, is equal to m into r into omega square. So all these are the three formulas for centripetal force. Okay, but this is the general formula for centripetal force. So in vector form also we can write this centripetal force, because force is a vector quantity. So the centripetal force is also vector quantity. So we will apply the vector quantity concept here. Minus m into v square upon r, this concept will keep as it is, minus m into v square upon r, and this r cap indicates what? R cap indicates what? Along the direction of r, along the direction of r. This f vector is along the direction of r. Please see here, this is the r here, this is the r, and this r vector direction is along this. So r vector is along this direction, but your fcp, that is nothing but centripetal force, is in this direction. R vector, that is the radius vector, is in this direction. Radius vector, always it is in this direction. If you are taken, here is the radius vector, so radius vector is in this direction. But centripetal force, that is fcp, is in this direction. R vector is in this direction and fcp is in this direction. Both are in opposite direction. That's why here there is a negative sign. So R vector is opposite to the that of centripetal force vector. That's why there is a negative sign. Same way here, m into r into omega square, but we are taken minus. Why minus? Because r vector and fcp vector both are in opposite direction. That's why we are taken the minus value here. Okay, I hope you understood the vector form of centripetal force. Okay, so next is the SI unit of centripetal force. So SI unit of centripetal force is nothing but Newton only. Okay, so force SI unit, whatever force SI unit is there, that is the Newton, that is only the SI unit of centripetal force. Okay, now next we will discuss some characteristics of centripetal force. So centripetal force is a real force. It is a real force, means it is always exists in a circular motion. It is a real force acting on a particle performing circular motion. So any particle which is performing circular motion, any particle which is performing circular motion, if the particle is moving like this, then there should be a centripetal force. Without centripetal force, the particle does not move in a circle. Why it does not move? If there is no force here acting, if there is no force acting, then this particle will move away from the center, or it will go away from the this radius or away from this circumference. Okay, so there should be a force that is known as the centripetal force to maintain this particle move in a circular manner or circular path. If the car is moving like this, if the car is moving on a curved path, if the car is moving on a curved path, this is the center of the that curved path, there also a centripetal force. Then only the car will maintain the friction or maintain the force so that the car will turn along this road. If there is no centripetal force, then the car will go away from this road. Okay, so I hope you understood. So every circular motion there is a centripetal force. So that is the first condition, that is the first concept. Real force acting on a particle performing circular force is the centripetal force. So second concept we will discuss, that is the necessary force. It is a necessary force. Without centripetal force, there is no circular motion. So it is always necessary force for the circular motion. Okay, to maintain the circular motion. That is the second characteristics of a centripetal force. Next we will discuss third point. its direction is different in different points. Its direction is different in different points. For example, see here, this is the circular path, and if the particle is here, initially the particle is here, the direction is like this. Okay, so direction is towards the center. If the particle is here, the direction is like this. So everywhere, every point, the direction is continuously changes. Okay, so direction is like this, direction is like this, direction is like this. So every point, the direction of the centripetal force continuously changes. So its direction is different in different points. So different points means these are the different points. Okay, so every point, there is a different direction. Next, fourth one we will discuss, that is the it acts along the radius. It acts along the radius and towards the center. Means what? So if the particle is moving in a circular path, it acts always towards the center. This force, whatever force is there, it always acts towards the center. Okay, I hope you understood the concept. These are the some characteristics of a centripetal force. So next we will discuss, that is the examples. These are the practical examples where the centripetal force exists. So first example we will take, when an object tied at the end of a string and revolve the string, then the tension, this word is very important, tension in the string provide centripetal force. For example, when one string is there, string means rope or any wire, okay, and one object is tied at the center, or one object is tied at one end, and this string is revolved like this. String is revolved in a circular manner. The string is revolved in a circular manner. What will happen? The object will revolve like this. The object will revolve around the circle. The object will revolve around the circle like this. It will revolve. Okay. So because of this revolution, there is a tension is produced within this string. Tension is produced. Tension is nothing but stretching. Stretching is produced within this string. Okay. So that stretching is known as the tension. Tension in the string. Which tension or which stretching provide the necessary centripetal force. Necessary centripetal force to revolve this object around the circle. Okay, so that is the first example where the centripetal forces exist. Okay, so second example we will take, if the car is traveling in a curved path, then friction provide the centripetal force. For example, now the we'll take one simple car here, and the car is giving like this curve path, turning like this. Whenever it is turning, the friction between the tire and the road provide the centripetal force, so that the car does not skid. Okay, so car will move very safely. Okay, so that friction is in between tire and the road, tire of the car and the road, the friction is generated, and that friction gives the necessary centripetal force, that is the FCP, which is along the radius and towards the center. That's why the car will not skid. Okay, I hope you understood. That is the second application or second practical example where the centripetal force exists. Third example we will discuss, that is the, if train is turning, then the rails push the wheels provide the centripetal force. So if train is turning like this, if the turn is like this, and same in car as well we taken, simple example. The train is turning like this. So there is a wheels or rails. Rails are there. Here everywhere rails are there. And these rails push the train. Push the train will give the necessary centripetal force. The this whatever rails are there. Rails means pattery. Train ki pattery. Okay. So these rails push the train so that the train does not skid away from the road or away from the rail. Okay. So it will, this whatever rails are there which push towards this center. That's why the train will go safely. That is also the centripetal force. Next we'll discuss, the moon revolve around the earth, the gravitational force provide the centripetal force. So when you consider there is a earth and there is a moon revolve, so moon revolve like this, moon revolve like this. So in between these earth and the moon there is a gravitational force. So that gravitational force provide the centripetal force. So that's why the moon does not move away. It will revolve around the earth. I hope you understood. The gravitational force is present between the earth and the moon, so that the moon does not move away. So the moon will rotate like this. So that is also the one example for centripetal force. So next we will discuss, that is the centrifugal force. So centrifugal force is denoted as FCF. Okay, F and suffix CF it is. Okay, so I told when the object or when the body is rotating in a circular pattern, when the particle or any object is rotating in a circular manner, there are two forces are exist. One is the centripetal force that already we discussed. This is the second force that is known as the centrifugal force, that is CFCF. One force will act towards the center and another force will act away from the center. Away from the center means away, outwards it will act. And this force, that is whatever we studied, that is the centripetal force will act, that is centripetal force is FCP will act towards the center, and centrifugal force, that is the FCF, will act away from the center. Okay, so this is the main difference between centrifugal force and the centripetal force. Okay, so second we will discuss, centrifugal force is a pseudo force. Pseudo means it is not a real force. It is not a real force. Not real. Not real, or we can write it as imaginary. Imaginary. Okay, I hope you understood. Pseudo meaning is what? Not real or imaginary. It is a imaginary force or pseudo force or not real force in circular motion. In circular motion, which acts along the radius. Along the radius means it will act along the radius only. So this is the along the radius. It will act along the radius and away from the center. Away from the center means it will act away from the center. Centripetal force act towards the center, and this centrifugal force act away from the center. That is the only main difference between centripetal and centrifugal force. Okay. Now they told not real force. So in example you will understand what is this not real force or imaginary force. Only you, now you should say centrifugal force is a pseudo force, force in circular motion which acts along the radius and away from the center. Okay, so by Newton's laws of motion, as we discussed in centripetal force, same concept we will apply for the centrifugal force also. By Newton's laws of motion, force is equal to what? Mass into acceleration. So force we will consider as the centrifugal force is equal to m into v into omega. Mass is the m. Acceleration we can write it as v into omega. V into omega. So m into V into omega, that is equal to m V square upon R. M we will keep as it is. Acceleration, again we can write it as V square upon R. That is equal to m again as it is. Acceleration we can write it as R into omega square. Okay, so this is the general formulas. These are the three general formulas for centrifugal force. So centrifugal force formula is also same, and centripetal force formula is also same. Centripetal force formula is also same. Okay, but in vector form it is little bit different. Vector form FCF vector is equal to, here it will come positive. Why positive? Because why positive? Because radius vector is also in this direction. Please see here, radius vector. So radius vector, already we discussed the term of radius vector is in this direction, and centrifugal force also is in this direction only. That's why both direction are same, radius vector direction and force of FCF, that is nothing but centrifugal force also in same direction. That's why in this formula plus will come, plus m v square upon r. R cap indicates what? It is the along the radius. Okay, is equal to m omega square into r vector. So r vector and FCF both are in same direction. That's why here plus will come, and the SI unit of FCF is equal to Newton. That already we discussed. SI unit of centripetal force and centrifugal force both are same. That is the Newton. I hope you understood the concepts.